is run away from these lies. Back to yesterday, save tonight. I feel the sun creeping up like tick tock. I'm trying to keep you in my head, but if not. So welcome to this Attitude Online video interview.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're really happy to have you.
Happy to be here.
First question. Is there a separation between Marielle in real life and Miss Barbados Marielle?
I wouldn't say so. I would say that both Marielles are the same. What you see is what you get. I don't try and, you know, act a certain way when I'm around certain people. I like to keep it real, as they say. And just be myself. That's what will get you far in the long run.
Definitely. So, what's your average Miss Barbados day like? What do you wake up and do all day?
Well, our Saturdays, I'd say, is the most busiest day. We wake up around 9 o'clock. Like this Saturday, for instance, we have movie morning with Variety Club at Olympus. So, wake up, go to Olympus. That's from 9 to 1. And then right after that, me and Sabia have reading room on 95.3 from 1 to 2 o'clock, and then straight after that from 2 o'clock to 6 o'clock we have training, and then we have dance rehearsals right after that. So that's a little bit of what we're doing. Sundays and like Fridays and Mondays and occasionally during the week, Leah and Tashino will plan like little one-off events for us to go to, or just go into like Land Rover and meet some sponsors and stuff like that. But it's good, I can't complain. Yeah, it's hard to like balance your whole work schedule as well, because obviously you have I work, and so you have to try and keep a balance and change everything. But I think we're doing so pretty good so far.
So between work and all this sporting stuff, how do you relax and when you do for downtime and such?
I go for a surf on afternoon.
And you surf?
Yes, I'm a surfer. I represented Barbados for 3 years.
Oh, really?
A few years back, yeah. But I don't surf competitively anymore. I just more do it for fun and, you know, just go out there and let go of everything. And
so, if one of your contestants had to describe you, like, 5 minutes for you, what do you think of it?
One of the contestants?
Yeah.
You'll probably say that I'm mad. But I still have my head on, hopefully they say that, which I do. They say that I'm nice. I bring food to them, so they can't say anything bad about me, I hope. They probably say that I'm the crazy one in the bunch. Me and Nicola are they. They say that I'm the white Nicola and she's the black Marielle, because we're like, our personalities are very similar, but
all
I can think of
and
say about me, nothing bad,
fingers crossed. Definitely. So, tell me about August 28th, the big night. Like, how do you think that'll go? What do you envision for it and stuff like that?
I envision that it's gonna go perfect.
Really?
There's gonna be no torn dresses, there's gonna be no slip-ups, there's gonna be no falling down. And yeah, I think it's gonna all run really smoothly, and hopefully that crown will fit my head and look very nice. I hope. Whoever's supposed to win will win, whoever's best at representing whoever it is. I'm sure all the girls will do a good job, like all of them are amazing. That's the thing, we all got like looks during that period of time, so hoping there's no cattiness on that last night.
So do you think you guys would have been friends if it wasn't for the pageant, or you know?
Right.
Do you think you guys would have been friends if it wasn't for the pageant?
Yeah,
right.
I think so, you know, with everyone, like, all the personalities mesh together, and I think that, like, some of the girls were really quiet at first, but we kind of, like, the loud ones kind of helped bring them onto their shelves.
So, Mario, what's the one thing that you learned, you know, throughout the pageant that you will always stay with you?
Be punctual, be on time. And they just taught us so much. Like, they taught us how to eat. I thought I knew how to eat, but apparently I've been eating wrong for the past 20 years. They teach you how to eat, they teach you how to sit down, they teach you how to do, like, everything. So, I don't know, you know, where we'd be without the team that MBW has behind them, because they're working so hard with all of us. And just, like, everything, like, take everything home, no matter what, you're going to come out on top of everything. It's just a learning experience altogether, as far as I see it.
So you think like younger girls look up to you and stuff because you're in the pageant, you think so?
Yeah, some of the girls, I see them like when I'm out and thinking, they look at me and it's not normal that you'd be out with somebody that's saying like, you're so and so, but I'd be out and they look at me like, you're Miss Barbie as well, pageant. Like, yeah. So it's cute, I like it. But.
So if they were watching this video, like what advice would you give them?
I tell them, follow your heart and do whatever you want to do inside. Don't listen to other people, take their advice and take it in and you know, hear what they have to say, but don't, you know, do whatever other people tell you to do. Follow your heart and what you want to do and follow your dreams.
So what do you lean on the most for support and stuff like that?
I lean on my parents. They've helped me a tremendous amount. Me and my mom have our little like squabbles because I just get frustrated sometimes. I'm like, I can't do this, and she then just screws my head back on and tells me, look, you're in it for the long run, you can't back out now. And so she definitely gives me a lot of support. My whole family and all of my friends, everybody is, you know, 100% behind me. So thank you all for that.